I'd like to talk about looking outside of ourselves for fulfillment, for spiritual understanding, to teachers, to anything really. Why do we do that? It's a very natural thing that happens from the day that we're very little, right? We learn about ourselves from the environment around us. This ball, my mother. And we take this kind of simple, innocent thing, and it becomes this habit over a lifetime of looking outside of ourselves for ourselves. This ball is going to give me a greater sense of myself. I'm going to understand myself vis-a-vis this ball and this house, my car, my marriage, my relationship, my spiritual practice. Be a light unto yourself, the Buddha said. The Satguru, the inner knower, the teacher within. Why do all these teachings ultimately point back to yourself? There's some great reflections out there to get. Wonderful teachings, wonderful beings. Nature herself is a wonderful reflection of the transparency of our own being that's not caught up in identity. And we fall in love with these examples. Certain beings who've let go of identity and are returned back to the natural state. And we fall in love with nature. It's because it's mirroring back to ourselves what we are, essentially. And it feels so good to have authentic mirroring. It's a relief, and it can be a little scary because the defensive walls of all the years of structure that's been put over in layers over ourselves get to be seen through. It's like, ouch. But there comes a time when we're ready for that. It's like, I've had enough. I had enough forgetting. I've been doing everything possible to remember. Many of us are in that boat when we're in this spiritual journey. And some people are still wondering, why don't I know who I am at this given point? After all this searching, all this work, give it up. Just stop. It's not getting you there because there's no there to get to. There. Do you have to move to get there? No. I understand. I really do. This outward momentum, this pull that we've been learning since we were little and mirrored by the world around us collectively, that our fulfillment and satisfaction and our sense of self lies outside of us. Right? And we hear so many times that it's here. Trust that. Of course it's here. Because it's you. It's your very own self that you're longing for. It's no one else. So as much as someone can be a great mirror, a wonderful reflection for you, in truth, they are your very own self that's being reflected back. That's what you're seeing. That's what you're falling in love with. The innocence in a child's face. That's what you are. That's what we are. And we're all so complicated, aren't we? But underneath that, we're super, super simple. And this truth thing is super, super simple. It's our natural state. What's complicated is what we've built up around us in our imagination, believing that we're somebody. And everything gets resolved in the heart. Everything. Everything returns back to the unconditioned and the unconditional that we are. And because we have these bodies, it feels like something. It feels, there's a felt sensation that arises. Unconditional love, beingness, presence. And people call it bliss. Sometimes it's just a simple felt sense of being here. A sense of you being here. That particularness that is you and no one else. How is that possible to be you and everything else at the same time? Well, there's no mystery there. Maybe the mind can't figure it out. As far as the mind goes, it's a huge mystery. You can't put it together in thought and in words. You know, these are stumblings. These are attempts. These are pointers to the mystery that's lived. The living mystery.